This weekend is Small Business Saturday. In today's episode, I'm going to talk about how corporates, especially the financial services industry, can support small businesses during this pandemic.
What does Small Business Saturday really mean this year for America's small companies?
This year is very unique. You know, we are in the midst of a pandemic, which is increasing in its ferocity every single day. I would say this crisis has actually multiplied from where we were during the summer. We have a hope of vaccination coming in, but it's still very rough next 2 or 3 months.
What more should the financial industry be doing to help small businesses at this important moment?
I think this noise is okay, but I think a lot of this noise is for corporates trying to brand themselves up and trying to show that, you know, they're very friendly to small businesses when actually they are the ones, you know, who are impacting the small businesses the most right now. And I think in real terms, you know, both the corporates, including financial services sector and the government, needs to take some very strong steps to help small businesses, including creating funds where they can help small businesses to invest more in digital technologies, you know, ability for smaller lenders to go digital at a faster pace. You know, more PPP funding is required right now for businesses. So I think these are very critical questions, and just, you know, running some ads or professing the support towards small businesses is not going to change the ground reality.
In your view, what is it that financial companies have to actually do in order to prove their support for small businesses?
I think majorly financial services companies will have to do 3 things. They will have to work with their clients to figure out a way that how they can get more financial support, whether in terms of more long-term loans or more aid, you know, coming in. I think the second thing they need to do at a war speed is digitization. And why? Because a good example is that, you know, government is trying to help a lot of small businesses with SBA loans, which are guaranteed by the federal government. But the banks are the one who administer it. And most of the banks do it still in an old-fashioned way that takes months and months and so much of paperwork. So if they digitize their processes and systems, then they can help businesses to get loans faster. They can help them to get it cheaper and also with less amount of paperwork and less hassles. So I think that's a great example of why banks need to go digital, you know, right away. I think the third thing is they need to help businesses plan in a post-pandemic world, you know, where they will get their demand back, how will they finance it. Again, the digital technologies will play a big role, because not only they need to provide them with digital platform for lending, but also digital platforms for ongoing planning, monitoring their own business.
How do you think a digital lending platform can play a part in that solution that lenders and banks have to provide to small businesses right now?
I think the biggest benefit is going to be speed, transparency, lower cost. Now, part of the cost savings they can actually pass off to the small businesses in terms of better pricing and lower fees. You know, ongoing risk monitoring is a lot better in digital environment, a lot easier, especially in this day and age. So that will help banks to have a better or a healthier risk practices, which will again help consumers and businesses to get better pricing, you know, less friction, less paperwork. And also, I think digitization is overall going to help them tremendously to, you know, cut their own cost, you know, which is required. Because if you don't have a healthy financial services system, then, you know, you cannot help your clients, especially small businesses.
Rohit, what is your Small Business Saturday message to everybody who's participating in this particular industry?
Yeah, my message for banks is that they need to really transform themselves. You know, what they were thinking about doing it in next 5 to 10 years, they have to plan it for next year. You know, they don't have a lot of time. You know, they need to act fast. They need to, you know, retool their own businesses in a very rapid fashion. Go digital, you know, act in a more flexible manner. You know, think about how you can incorporate a lot of government programs into your own programs. You know, how do you help your small business clients? You know, for small businesses, the way they will have to invest more in digital, any kind of small business now, you know, that's the way forward. They cannot just hope that, okay, I can survive being an offline business anymore. And I think for policymakers, the message is extremely clear. You know, stop fighting. You know, just get down to the job of, you know, helping small businesses right now, because they're in trouble. This trouble is increasing, and this is like a patient is in ICU today, and if you're going to try to put him on ventilator in 3 months' time, then, you know, that's not going to work. My take is that this Small Business Saturday is extremely significant. All of us, including corporates, financial services sector and policymakers need to help small businesses get through this crisis and thrive after the pandemic. Small businesses are the engine of growth for America, and we need to support them all around the year.